Welcome to this edition of Exhibit Talk. We are here in the Viva Baseball exhibit with John Odell, the Curator of History and Research at the Baseball Hall of Fame. John, this exhibit opened in 2009 with special guests Hall of Famers Orlando Cepeda and Juan Marichal. Tell me about it.
Yes, this is one of our newest exhibits. Viva Baseball talks about the story of Latinos in the game of baseball. We began with the idea that we would be celebrating the modern Latins in the game. As we began doing research, we found out there was so much more than we had ever imagined. And it begins back in Latin America, in those countries. And the stories of baseball and how it grew up and became the national pastimes of those countries as well was one of the first things that we started with. Baseball in the Caribbean really began in Cuba. And although many people think and expect that it's going to be because the United States brought the game to Cuba, the reality is that it's Cubans who brought the game to Cuba and then became the apostles of baseball, as is called down throughout the Caribbean. The Cubans were Cuban students who had come to the United States, learned baseball, and then gone back down to Cuba and taught the game to the people of Cuba, who took to it immediately, loved the game, and it immediately became a great passion in Cuba and then spread throughout that island. And then, because Cubans were great travelers throughout the Caribbean, they took the game with them to the east coast of Mexico, to Puerto Rico, to the Dominican Republic, to the northern coast of Venezuela. Wherever Cubans went to trade, they brought baseball with them. The Dominican Republic today is where Cuba used to be. Cuba used to be the great source of baseball for the United States from the Caribbean, but that role has really been taken up today by the Dominican Republic. Some great, great rivalries in the Dominican Republic between Santiago and Santo Domingo, Licey in Santo Domingo, and Las Águilas in Santiago. Also, Escogido, these are great teams with great histories that go back a long time. In between those two countries, Puerto Rico had a great, great run of ball players. We have on exhibit the Cangrejeros jersey from the 1950s. That's the era when players like Roberto Clemente and Willie Mays played together on teams. Mexico and Venezuela, also great baseball countries. Mexico, very interestingly, is mostly soccer, but in the areas where baseball is king, it's really the king.
And the exhibit is entirely bilingual.
The exhibit is entirely bilingual. When we were creating it, we realized that this is a Spanish-speaking story. That's one of the elements that Native Latinos had to overcome when they came to the United States. And one of the things that's been very interesting, when we did our research, We discovered here at the Hall of Fame that there weren't a lot of people who came and spoke Spanish. But when we opened up this exhibit in Spanish, we find that there are a lot more bilingual people who come, and visitors who speak Spanish with one another when they're in this area, but speak English in other areas.
John, when this exhibit opened in 2009, 24% of opening day rosters in Major League Baseball were Latino-born players. There were also several Hall of Famers.
That's exactly right. And one of the things that we talk about here in this exhibit are the things that draw the Caribbean players together. Each country had its own history, but in aggregate, they also held some things in common. The stories of playing the game, regardless of how much or how little they had in terms of equipment, creating equipment when they needed to. The love of the game is something that is really common throughout the Caribbean, and the Hall of Famers talk about that. We interviewed them, asking them questions, both in English and in Spanish. And so when you come to this exhibit, you can press a button and get a chance to hear in the Hall of Famers, or sometimes an All-Star's own words, the story of playing the game, what it means to play the game in the Caribbean, and how they feel about being a Latino playing the game in the United States.
John, the Hall of Fame has explored the Latin love affair with baseball, not only here in the exhibit in the museum, but elsewhere as well.
That's right. The exhibit here in the museum talks about the entire history of baseball down in the Caribbean and its intersection with baseball here in the United States. But we also wanted to be able to give back a little bit to Latin America in recognition of all that they've given to us. And so not long ago, we also took some plaques down to Puerto Rico of Latin American Hall of Famers, Latino Hall of Famers, to great crowds down there.
It must have been a nice special treat for them. Thank you for joining us on this edition of Exhibit Talk here in Viva Baseball. You can learn more about the Latin love affair with baseball on our website at baseballhall.org.